been here?
Trying to hold my hand on the base is okay.
in one very important way. We are all winners, achievers, accomplishers of our goals. We should be proud. All people begin their lives with dreams and goals, but as change occurs and obstacles and problems become part of their lives, many people stop their upward climb. They move forward only until they reach an imaginary barrier, then stop.
our student body. This college center will be completed in June of 1988. We also saw the construction of a temporary building called the Poplar, which houses the student activities, the college center, and student services offices. The school is also receiving funding for a new phase of the business building. It also has plans to complete a new daycare center in the works. Student involvement has grown tremendously. Our student body offices this year have changed from 7 to 6, which has been able to enhance and help our student body and student government grow. We've also changed our student center to an appointing system. This year our elections were great. We came from a record 13% last year to an all-time record of 17% this year, which is second in the state among colleges and universities. We have seen the exception of basketball program, and watched the first year basketball team
Thank you. because of the training programs to work closely with industry, we train our efforts to meet this challenge. The fourth challenge is college addresses to move from primary to service agency, leading to the institution. In its earlier years, your primary role was indeed to provide for a service to those who are seeking a job. Important as that is, you have also the challenge of becoming identified as a group, as an educational institution, as a college. I congratulate the basketball team, who has done remarkably well. I congratulate Randy, the male officers, who served you well, as you have identified yourself not just as a service agency for job preparation, but all the exciting benefits that come from being a full-fledged collegiate institution. The fifth challenge you face is that of moving from Honolulu to being a college campus. The beautiful construction way on your campus today in Honolulu is evidence of meeting that challenge. As a member of the state legislature, it was part of my enjoyable opportunity to be supportive of the growth of this campus. And in the final leadership of President Carnahan and this year's administration, I have seen advocacy, excellent advocacy, to provide your needs and give you the physical facilities that you need to have your The fifth challenge is the sixth challenge in moving from adjunct faculty to professionalization of the teaching staff. I was impressed as I listened to the awards that are coming, the awards of those distinguished faculty and staff received tonight. You are becoming every day more professional. The number of degrees, graduate programs represented, the institution represented, the professional qualities that you bring to the service of faculty and staff are evidence. Seventh concern is to move from having an individual focus to truly becoming, as President Carnahan indicated already, a community college. You have been a community college, in fact, for many years. And the breadth of your program and the breadth of your offerings is evidence that you're reaching out to many things in this remarkable community, and you're becoming more a part of that each day. And finally, I guess it's one of the things in many ways that you accept the challenge of, in some ways, years ago, being seen as a becoming a full citizen and eventually a leader. I have great hopes and great dreams, as you have, for this institution. And I believe they will come to you and all recognize for being a very excellent vocational technical institution. But as you become now a first-rate community college, that will become a leader in community college program, not only in this state, but in this region and in this nation. I know the commitment is there for leadership, and I certainly hope that we will be supportive as these attitudes. And just a few observations, members of the faculty, before I address you graduates. You still face challenges to maintain your flexibility. observation that John Harvard is marvelous at Bill Excellence. He said, for instance, teachers are fond of saying that education is a lifelong process, and yet it's something that no universal or grand sense needs to be told. Why does teachers keep on saying it? It isn't though they love sentiments or love work or better handling, though they do. It isn't that they underestimate their audience. The truth is they know something that their listeners do not know. Something that can never be fully communicated. No matter how far the doors were asked, the young person may have the idea that education is a lifelong process. He can never know it with the poignancy, with the deeply etched clarity, with the overtones of satisfaction when he read the little person knows it. The young person is not going to make enough mistakes that cannot be repaired. He's not going to pass in a close in a row that cannot be retraced. And he's not going to experience the truth that learning through life is by no means continuous and by no means universal. If it were, age and wisdom would be perfectly correlated, and there would be no such thing as an old fool. The sad truth is that many of us, the learning process comes to an end very early indeed. I hope you will leave tonight with the commitment that the learning that you have had in your life will continue on, and you will keep on learning and expanding your vision of education being a lifelong process. And if you want to say anyone who stops learning is old, whether they're 20 or 80, anyone who keeps learning stays young. The greatest thing in life is to keep your mind going. Now there are several ways you can do that, and some of your students talk about it at that time. Some of you will continue with formal education in a four-year institution. For you, Salt Lake Community College has provided an excellent foundation of a general education. Armed with an associate degree, you can now proceed on to a bachelor's degree, and perhaps even a master's for your doctorate. And I commend those of you in plan on doing it. For those of you who desire this, there are great opportunities ahead to continue in a formal instruction program. Others will go into the workforce, and for you, Salt Lake Community College has provided a criminal degree and an opportunity to enter the world of work and apply your skills in meaningful settings. I hope if you do so, you will continue to increase your vocational expertise. It's interesting to note that in recent years, more money in this country is spent on industry training than on higher education in this country. I hope you will learn that and take advantage of your employer programs, but the main opportunity is to increase your skills, to become more proficient at your profession. Others will be able to be trained when times for career changes come. And there are many opportunities in life, although you may need formal education for a period, you can yet return and be prepared for new vocational, for new professional opportunities. Now, many ways in which we can serve as volunteer organizations, a neighbor of council, on county committees, on task force, in the PTA, the Red Cross, the Boy Scouts. We can serve in service organizations and serve anywhere we know with Lions, Clubs, Voters, all the others we have, both men and women. And we need to become involved in the political process. Politics is not a dirty word, but politics can be dirty. And if we fail to involve ourselves in the political process, we will disaffect ourselves. state honor